Sarge, I'm about ready to cave then. Are we going to stay here for a while?
Lieutenant's coming. Ask him.
Have our orders, sir?
I'm afraid so, Fisher.
Lieutenant, we've been pushing it steady for the last 48 hours.
Everybody's putting in overtime these days, Sergeant.
What the Sergeant's saying, Lieutenant.
I know what he's trying to say, Marks. Our orders are, we're to be the first outfit to use this village for rest and recreation.
Rest and recreation?
What, Lieutenant, you mean we're going to stay here for real?
Well, it's about time!
Yeah! Hold up.
I've had a little
time. I just spoke to Major Jample. Battalion is in Division Reserve, and this town is to be our headquarters. He said the men of battalion are to use whatever limited recreational facilities are available. You fellas are going to have to goof off for a couple of days.
You did say goof off, didn't you, Lieutenant?
That's practically an order.
I think I'll take you up on that, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Finally going to write that long letter to the wife and kids.
Lieutenant, that little joke's going to cost you a drink.
That's war, Sergeant.
Selmer Production. Combat. Starring Rick Jason. Morrow. Co-starring Gail Coby.
The other side.
Thank you.
my boy, alive.
Des Américains, des Américains.
Monsieur, allez-vous des cigarettes? Avez-vous des cigarettes américaines? Monsieur, je vous en prie. Des cigarettes américaines?
No, nothing. I guess he's gone.
Ask them if they've seen anything go by.
Vous avez vu quelqu'un passer par ici?
Non, personne, non, non, rien vu.
Monsieur, avez-vous des cigarettes américaines?
Je vous en prie.
Je vous en prie, des cigarettes américaines.
Cage, Little John, take the houses on this side. Kirby, Marks,
yes?
Go through the houses on the other side.
Oh, Sarge's gone. He's a mile away by now.
Look anyway.
Fisher's dead, sir.
He's been wanting to write that long letter home for the last 2 weeks.
Germans pulled out of this town 4 hours ago. If the sniper didn't leave with him, maybe he's figuring on not leaving at all.
Maybe he just wanted to get a last shot in before he took off.
Or maybe he's a hard case. They go down fighting tight. You keep checking every room of every building in this town. I want that sniper.
I told you, Sarge, he left.
48 hours off and we gotta spend it chasing a ghost.
Well, keep moving, keep looking. Let's go.
Hey, Sarge.
So we told everybody to keep off the streets.
Il y a un franc-tireur dans le village. Il y a un franc-tireur dans le village. On vous a demandé de ne pas rester dans les rues jusqu'à temps qu'on l'abatte. Vous avez compris?
Je n'ai aucune raison d'avoir peur. Je ne suis pas un Canadien. C'est vous qui êtes le soldat. Vous portez l'uniforme de l'armée américaine.
He said he's not worried, said the sniper's not after him, he's after us.
How come he's so sure?
On se fait-il, vous en êtes si sûr?
Let him go. Let him go for now. Let's keep looking. Let's go.
English, honey?
We. Oui. I was taught English by the sisters at the convent.
Hey, that's good. Listen, I gotta ask you a couple of questions about the sniper. The one that shot the GI out there in the street a little while ago. Understand? Sniper. Compris?
Oui. Na?
Hey, you and me understand each other pretty good, you know that? Like to say back in the States, what time you gonna get off here later? I just thought I'd ask you. All I'm trying to do is be friendly now. The least that you could do is just cooperate a little bit with your liberators.
Well, honey, I ain't gonna hurt you.
Now, look, I'm a lonely GI, you understand? There's no reason in the world why you and me can't go out together tonight. We get to know each other a little bit.
Stay away from me.
You pack a real wallet, don't you? We could use you up the front. You're a regular tiger, you know that?
Lay off, Kirby. Just supposed to be out looking for that sniper.
Look, you said to ask questions, Sergeant. Now, that's exactly what I was doing.
I know what you're doing.
Laissez-le faire, Sergeant. Avec Françoise, ça n'a aucune importance.
All right, the sniper.
What else?
I'm sorry, but Kirby gets out of line sometimes.
Matt?
What did that guy say just now in there about the girl?
Oh, that guy? He said you shouldn't have leaned on Kirby so much. The girl wasn't worth it.
Oh, yeah?
Why don't you paint a target on your chest?
Sarge, you don't let that sniper get on your nerves.
Come on, get inside. Get inside.
Hey, Kirby. What did he say? We gonna get some recreation?
Yeah, as soon as the war's over.
Checkmate King, too. Yes, sir. We're almost secure. We got into town, we got hit by a sniper. Lost one man.
Hello, Marcel.
We'll expect you about noon, sir. Over. Yes, sir, I'm sure we will. Out. Anything?
We've had a very quiet night.
Our sniper is sleeping.
Maybe, but we haven't. Men are getting on edge. They think we're wasting a lot of time. In this village, 15 hours, no rest, no recreation. The men need a breather.
Saunders, in a few hours, there'll be a couple of hundred men in this village. Now, they'll be tired, too. You want to take the responsibility for their safety?
All right, what are we going to do? We searched every building, every street in this village, and there's not a trace of them.
It was Major Jample at battalion. I told him about our sniper. He expressed confidence that we will have remedied the situation by the time he arrives.
Still in the cafe talking to the lieutenant.
Sniper detail, huh?
Yeah, I guess so.
Hey, how about one of those, huh?
We better get off the street, you hear? Just going inside.
Where'd it come from?
I don't know.
He's dead, Sergeant. You still wonder if there's snipers in town?
Sergeant, it must have come from someplace up there.
All right, take that search. Go on.
Move!
All right, get inside. Off the streets! Move! Take the rest of the buildings at the side. Well, not a trace. Keep the villagers off the street till this thing is settled.
I don't want to talk to you.
What do you think you're doing, Saunders?
Lieutenant, we tangled with him yesterday.
He doesn't like Americans. And he seems to be sure he won't get shot at. I want to know why.
Est-ce la peur et la confusion qui vous fait abuser de ce pauvre Français? Vos canons ont démoli sa maison, tué sa femme et son petit bébé. Laissez-le donc tranquille, le pauvre gars, voyons.
What is he saying, Cage?
You better let him go, Sergeant. 3 days ago, our artillery hit his house, killed his wife, his kid.
poor guy's out of his mind with grief.
Tell him I'm sorry.
On regrette, vieux. On sympathise. On sympathise avec toi.
Allez, rentrez dans la maison.
Oui. Venez avec moi, mon petit gars. Venez, come on.
Les Américains arrivent. Tu dois partir. Tu dois quitter. Hans. Oh mon Dieu.
Keeps changing his position. He can see us, but we can't see him. All right. We'll let him think we're pulling out. Take the men, head up the road, turn around and double back. You and Case check the buildings at the edge of town.
Let's hope he falls for it and gets careless. Let's go.
John, you head back that way.
Doc.
Davis, the other way.
Kirby.
Yeah.
You take the other side. Stay wide.
Okay.
You're on me. Move on.
Vous fabriquez là, les enfants. C'est pas le temps de jouer dans les rues.
Nous cherchons quel ardeur.
This is looking for the sniper.
Nous sommes sûrs que vous avez besoin d'aide.
And I think we need his help.
Yeah, well, maybe he's right.
Il y a quelques buildings déserts et nous avons vu quelqu'un rentrer dans la vieille usine.
I saw it. There's some deserted buildings over there. And you saw someone entering the old factory.
Factory. Let's keep him off the streets. Tell him to go home. And, thank him.
Allez, les gars, restez pas dans les rues. Rentrez à la maison. Vous avez compris?
Vous allez nous appeler si vous avez besoin d'aide.
And now he thinks we have to call him if we need help.
Yeah, okay. Allez, allez.
Allez, rentrez, hein? Et merci.
Great. Let's take a look at that factory.
Thank you.
Let's escape a bit.
Lächle, Françoise, lächle, wir sind Lieblinge. Komm, lächle.
How's the girl from the cafe?
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bonjour, mademoiselle.
Hello, sergeant.
What are you doing out here? You were told to stay in the house off the streets.
Oh, we went for a walk.
Yeah, well, you better get back to the village. Stay inside, the both of you, huh?
Oui. Sergeant, you are not angry.
No, Francois, I'm not angry.
Bonjour.
You didn't happen to see a man along this road, did you? Alone near the ruins of the factory?
No. No. Bonjour.
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 This sniper is why he's in business in the first place. What's he trying to do? What is he trying to prove?
That he hasn't lost, no matter what's happened to his outfit.
Hey. Sniper. I found the sniper.
He just lives here.
Maybe he'll come back.
And if he's seen us come in.
What do we do now?
Tell you what we do. Let's put back everything just the way we found it. We'll walk out of here just the way we came in.
sure that, one, the sniper's not wearing uniform, two, he's in town to stay, and three, we have no idea where or when he's going to hit next.
I think we should stake out at the factory and wait for him.
Maybe. But if he ever saw you there, he'd never return.
Maybe he didn't see us.
Maybe he didn't. Maybe, maybe, maybe. Headquarters company's due in 20 minutes. I'll send Brockmeyer and Little John down to the factory.
What do I do in the meantime?
Stay put. Close by, anyhow. This is our command post.
Right.
Sergeant, would you like a little more coffee?
Yes, please.
Would you like some cheese, Sergeant?
No, I'm not very hungry right now.
I will leave it here. Perhaps later you would like some.
What's the matter, Francois? Sniper? You seem different than the other people in this village. Kirby told me you learned English in a convent.
Oui.
Is that what you wanted to be? A nun?
Oh. I might have become one of them one day.
What happened? War?
No. It was before the war.
And why did you change your mind?
I will tell you something. When I was 14, I came to the village one day to buy some thread for the sisters. It was a little privilege. The mayor's son, he took me to his house. I was so young. No one would believe me. No one would forgive me. No concern for you. I'm sorry.
You're sorry for me, you're sorry for yourself. You bear a grudge a long time.
You make one mistake, the others, they come very easily.
Why did you stay here? Why didn't you leave?
Because I have a father. He's very old. He needs me.
And after he's gone, what reason are you going to find to keep hating?
Why do you talk to me this way?
Let's just say I've seen a lot of people carry a bigger cross than you. And most of them make the best of it.
I do not care about living. I have been dying a little bit each day. If I do not care about living, what does it matter to you how I feel?
I don't know, I guess I'm tired. Tired of seeing everything destroyed and ruined. I know there's a reason for it, I know, and I had to learn to accept it. The war. But Joe, you haven't got that reason. You're young, you're attractive, and there's something very, very nice about you. Now, if somebody like you doesn't want to live, all this is just... it's useless.
Mm-hmm.
Now, check the back. Hey, ask them if they've seen anybody.
Dites, madame, vous avez vu passer quelqu'un avec un fusil?
Non, nous n'avons vu passer personne par ici avec un fusil.
Nothing.
Thank you. Francois. Why?
I was going to him to tell him to leave.
But you shouted at me. You won me.
Because you were kind. Please try to understand. To be alone is a very bad thing. The German Hans. I went to him so I would not be alone.
Pretty close, Sergeant. I can now see if Major Jappel's there. Get my report.
Lieutenant.
The girl. There's no reason for telling her part in it, is there?
Is there any reason not to?
Well, it's all over now. What good is it going to do? You see, this town never gave her anything. Looked down on her. All she needed was someone to hang on to. Someone. I guess she found them.
We lost two men.
I know. She died saving my life.
All right, Sergeant.
And now he thinks we have to call him if we need help.
Yeah, okay. Allez, allez.
Allez, rentrez, hein? Et merci.
Great.
Let's take a look at that factory.
Lächle, Françoise, lächle. Wir sind Lieblinge. Komm, lächle.
How's the girl from the cafe?
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bonjour, mademoiselle.
Hello, sergeant.
What are you doing out here? You were told to stay in the house, off the streets.
Oh, we went for a walk.
Yeah, well, you better get back to the village. Stay inside, the both of you, huh?
Oui. Sergeant, you are not angry.
No, Francois, I'm not angry.
Bonjour.
You didn't happen to see a man along this road, did you? Alone near the ruins of the factory?
No. No. Bonjour.
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 Jason. And Vic Morrow. Co-starring Gail Coby.
Oh,
Joby, yeah. Brought mine to the other side.
Les Américains arrivent. Tu dois partir. Tu dois quitter. Hans. Oh mon Dieu.
Keeps changing his position. He can see us, but we can't see him. All right. We'll let him think we're pulling out. Take the men, head up the road, turn around and double back. You and Case check the buildings at the edge of town.
Let's hope he falls for it and gets careless. Let's go.
John, you head back that way.
Doc?
Davis, the other way. Kirby?
Yeah.
You take the other side. Stay wide.
Okay.
You're on me. Move on.
Stay here for a while.
Lieutenant's coming. Ask him.
Hey, Lieutenant. Hey, Lieutenant.
You have our orders, sir?
I'm afraid so, Fisher.
Lieutenant, we've been pushing it steady for the last 48 hours.
Everybody's putting in overtime these days, Sergeant.
What the Sergeant's saying, Lieutenant.
I know what he's trying to say, Marks. Our orders are, we're to be the first outfit to use this village for rest and recreation.
Rest and recreation?
What, Lieutenant, you mean we're gonna stay here for real?
Well, it's about time!
Yeah! Hold up.
I've had a little time.
I just spoke to Major Jample. Battalion is in division reserve, and this town is to be our headquarters. He said the men of battalion are to use whatever limited recreational facilities are available. You fellas are gonna have to goof off for a couple of days.
You did say goof off, didn't you, Lieutenant?
That's practically an order.
I think I'll take you up on that, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Finally gonna write that long letter to the wife and kids.
Lieutenant, that little joke's gonna cost you a drink.
That's war, Sergeant.
Selmer Production. Combat. Starring Rick Jason. Morrow. Co-starring Gail Coby.
Sergeant, you still one of the snipers in town?
Sergeant, we must have come someplace up there.
All right, take that, sir. Go on.
Move!
All right, get inside. Off the streets! Move! Check the rest of the buildings on the side. Well, not a trace. Keep the villagers off the street till this thing is settled. What do you think you're doing, Saunders?
Lieutenant, we tangled with him yesterday.
He doesn't like Americans. And he seems to be sure he won't get shot at. I want to know why.
Est-ce l'affaire et la confusion qui vous fait abuser de ce pauvre Français? Vos canons ont démoli sa maison, tué sa femme et son petit bébé. Laissez-le donc tranquille, le pauvre gars, voyons.
What is he saying, Cage?
You better let him go, Sergeant. 3 days ago, our artillery hit his house, killed his wife, his kid. Poor guy's out of his mind.
all right.
He ran out. Check the back.
Hey, ask them if they've seen anybody.
Dites, madame, vous avez vu passer quelqu'un avec un fusil?
Non, nous n'avons vu passer personne par ici avec un fusil.
Nothing.
Would you like some cheese, Sergeant?
No, I'm not very hungry right now.
I will leave it here. Perhaps later you would like some.
What's the matter, Francois? Sniper? You seem different than the other people in this village. Kirby told me you learned English in a convent.
Oui.
Is that what you wanted to be? A nun?
Oh. I might have become one of them one day.
What happened? War?
It was before the war.
And why did you change your mind?
I will tell you something. When I was 14, I came to the village one day to buy some thread for the sisters. It was a little privilege. The mayor's son, he took me to his house. I was so young. No one would believe me. No one would forgive me. No concern for you. I'm sorry.
You're sorry for me, you're sorry for yourself. You bear a grudge a long time.
You make one mistake. The others, they come very easily.
Why didn't you stay here? Why didn't you leave?
Because I have a father. He's very old. He needs me.
And after he's gone, what reason are you going to find to keep hating?
Why do you talk to me this way?
Let's just say I've seen a lot of people carry a bigger cross than you. And most of them make the best of it.
I do not care about living. I have been dying a little bit each day. If I do not care...
What did that guy say just now in there about the girl?
Oh, that guy? He said you shouldn't have leaned on Kirby so much. The girl wasn't worth it.
Oh, yeah? Somebody lives here. Hey.
Sniper. I found the sniper.
He just lives here.
Maybe he'll come back.
And if he's seen us come in.
What do we do now?
Say, well, let's put back everything just the way we found it. We'll walk out of here just the way we came in.
pretty sure that one, the sniper's not wearing uniform. Two, he's in town to stay. And three, we have no idea where or when he's going to hit next.
I think we should stick out of the factory and wait for him.
Maybe. But if he ever saw you there, he'd never return.
Maybe he didn't see us.
Maybe he didn't. Maybe. Headquarters company's due in 20 minutes. I'll send Brockmeyer and Little John down to the factory.
What do I do in the meantime?
Stay put. Close by, anyhow. This is our command post.
Right.
Sergeant, would you like a little more coffee?
Yes, please.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry for me, you're sorry for yourself. You bear a grudge a long time.
You make one mistake, the others, they come very easily.
Why did you stay here? Why didn't you leave?
Because I have a father. He's very old. He needs me.
And after he's gone, what reason are you going to find to keep hating?
Why do you talk to me this way?
Let's just say I've seen a lot of people carry a bigger cross than you. And most of them make the best of it.
I do not care about living. I have been dying a little bit each day. If I do not care about living, what does it matter to you how I feel?
I don't know, I guess I'm tired. Tired of seeing everything destroyed and ruined. I know there's a reason for it, I know, and I had to learn to accept it. The war. But Joe, you haven't got that reason. You're young, you're attractive, and there's something very, very nice about you. Now, if somebody like you doesn't want to live, all this is just... it's useless.
Thank you.